Hey, family. I wanted to talk to you about my trip and about what's been going on with me. And like I said, this was the easiest way I knew how to do it. I'm doing this with my Kindle, so this is the first time I've tried to video like this. So just bear with me. I've got to wear my glasses. I've got something going on with my eyes, and the light is glaring at it, but I can't see if I don't have them on. So here goes. I know y'all know that I've been having a lot of problems this past year. So I've had physical problems, I've had mental problems, and I've had spiritual problems. And so I don't know how much you all know about everything that's been going on with me, but I know you saw me at the family reunion, and I was a mess. And a lot of that was due to medicines I was taking, and I have taken myself off of those, and I'm doing much, much better. But this past year has been really, really hard for me spiritually, and that's what really bothered me. I have not been able to pray at all for a year, and I just was having all kinds of problems. So I felt like this trip to Nicaragua was not a good idea. I felt like I was being a hypocrite. I felt like there was no reason for me to go because, you know, what could I do for these people? And I had lost all of my joy. I used to sing and dance all the time around the house, you know, sing at church and stuff. I hadn't been singing. I hadn't sang at church in a long, long time. I didn't bebop around the house or nothing. I was just here. So anyway, I did go on the trip. It was fantastic, and I just want to tell you a little bit about it. God had been speaking to me since we left here, and we went on home visitation on Tuesday, and I had never done that before, hadn't done that over there, hadn't done it here. As you all know, I'm a big scaredy cat. I get really, really nervous, can't talk to people, so I had never done it. Well, I had to do it this time because we were doing it as a team. So they split us up into several groups. We had a preacher, which I was with Mark, me, one, another of my team, and an interpreter, and then a lady from the church. And we had specific houses that we were going to. And so we went to, I think, four houses and talked to some people. And after we went to those houses, the lady from the church that was taking us around said she'd like for us to go to her house. So we went to her house, and I know all her family, or so I thought, and I'm friends with them all on Facebook. She's got several children. They're just beautiful, wonderful family. But we all got into their little house, and these houses, we were in a really poor section, you know, mud floors and all that. But we were all in this little room together, and the lady, her name is Nora, she said, "My son is not saved, and I'd like for you to talk to him." And, you know, just put him right on the spot, but he didn't seem to mind. They're so different over there. And he was very comfortable and everything. So Mark started talking to him about his salvation. And he said he knew who God was. And he said, "I could easily tell you that I'll accept Christ as my Savior to make the family happy. But," he said, "I know that I'm not ready for that." He said, "I've got friends that are not the best people. They use bad language and everything. And I'm just not ready to become a Christian." And so, you know, Mark kept talking to him, and he agreed to come to church on Wednesday night. So Mark was feeling like he needed to back off a little bit. About the time he said that he had felt like he needed to back off, I had the strong feeling to say something to this guy. Now, this is not me. I don't talk to people. I don't witness to people. I don't ever do that. And I, not only was it a strong feeling to do that, but a certain thing to say to him. So I said, "Mark, can I say something?" And he looked like he was about to hit the floor in shock. And he said, "Sure." And I said, "Do you know how much Jesus loves you?" He loves you this much. And I held my arms out like Jesus on the cross. Now, this is what God placed on my heart to say. I said, He loves you this much. He loved you so much that He took a nail right here. And He loved you so much that He took a nail right here. He loved you so much that He took a nail in His feet. He loved you so much that He hung there and He died. And He did that just for you so that you could be saved. And that's basically what I said. And he was very respectful and seemed very appreciative that we were concerned about him. But he said, you know, he wasn't ready for that. So we left, and Mark was very hopeful that he would be there on Wednesday night, and I was pretty sure he would not be. Well, we arrived at the church on Wednesday night, and he was already there. So he came to the service. So we were glad about that. And I was really surprised. And we had another Pastor Mark with us, and he was preaching Wednesday night. So he was preaching, and all of a sudden, he says, "Do you know how much Jesus loves you? He loves you this much." It about floored me. It went all through me. And I was just like, "God, I know you are speaking right to me." And, it really shook me up. And so he got finished with his sermon, and he was given the invitation. Several people went forward, and he went over and he was praying with them. The music was playing, and it went on for a while. So my Mark went up, and he continued with the invitation. And as soon as he started with the invitation again, the young man that said he was not ready to be saved came forward. And thought I wasn't going to be able to do this without crying again. I've cried so many times telling it. Needless to say, I dropped my head, and I was just boo-hooing. And I couldn't believe that God had worked through me and told me something specific to say to him. And then it was said, and I don't know if that had anything to do with him coming forward. You know, probably not, but to me, it was a big deal. And it was a sign for me. And it was like God was saying, you know, Sherry, you need to let this go. You need to get your joy back. And so Mark started praying with him. And the other Pastor Mark got back on the microphone, and he said a few words, and he put the mic down. They were still playing the music, and I just had to go up. I went up boo-hooing, and I put my arms around the other Pastor Mark's neck, and I was crying so hard that I couldn't tell him why I was up there. And so he just let me cry for a while, and I guess he assumed that I was just really, my heart was breaking for the people, and I was wanting them all to know God and everything. And so he starts praying, and he says, "God, me and Sherry, we love you, and we want the people of San Marcos to love you just as much as we do." And he said, if there is a hardened heart here, please soften that heart. And he prayed a little bit more. When he got finished, I pulled him down so I could talk into his ear because it was really loud in there. I said, "That heart that you just prayed for, that hardened heart, it was mine." And I said, I hadn't been able to pray in a year, and I said a few things to him, and so he was just crying along with me and praising God. He stopped and he said, "Sherry, look up. Look around you." And I looked up, and my whole team was surrounding me and Pastor Mark. They were holding hands in a circle around me, and they were praying. They didn't know what they were praying for, but they knew that I needed it. Around that circle of my team members, there was another circle on the outside of the people from the church, and they were praying. I had no idea anybody else was up there except for me and Pastor Mark. And I tell you, That is something that I would never be able to explain, the feeling that came over me when I looked up and I saw all those people around me praying for me. And this trip, as my friend Paula from Georgia said, this trip was for you, wasn't it? This trip was for me. And I'm so very thankful that I didn't let the devil talk me out of going on the trip. And I have got my joy back. And I've been dancing and singing and all that good stuff. I just wanted you guys to know. I wanted to tell you my little story. And that's kind of hard to type out. So I know this was long. But I love you guys. I love you so much. Please keep praying for me. And I'll keep praying for you because I can pray now. I love you guys. Bye.